All right, Mr. Collins, the game is checkers. Your move, Mr. Collins.
Oh, sorry, I was lost in thought.
Lost is an excellent choice of words. Your move, Mr. Collins.
She's thought to be proud by many, but I've never seen anything but affability in her.
Your move, Mr. Garland.
I think you said she is a widow. Has she any family?
One daughter.
What sort of young lady is she? She handsome.
A very charming young lady indeed, but unfortunately of a sickly constitution.
Has she been presented at court?
Her indifferent state of health prevents that. As they told Lady Catherine, the British court is deprived of the RHS ornament.
As you can tell, Mr. Collins, I'm your last king in a corner.
Ah, yes, a trivial game.
Now, will you excuse me? I shall retire to my library.
Interesting. Unfortunately, they are out. They would have loved it. Jane, as you know, is still visiting Medfield.
Mr. Bingley has taken quite an interest.
Yes, and how happy I will be when my daughters are well married and settled.
Quite right. May I please have a word with Miss Elizabeth this afternoon?
Oh, yes, certainly. I'm sure she'll love it.
And will you let me know when Miss Elizabeth returns?
Of course, I shall speak to her as soon as she comes in.
Thank you.
Oh, Mr. Bennett!
Go away!
How can you understand my feelings? You are not a mother!
Dear Charlotte.
Oh, Charlotte! Hello!
I promised Papa I'd make some mince pies, and nothing would do without her rest of your cookies.
Cook will be flattered. Lizzie. Mr. Collins wishes to speak to you today. He's in the garden.
A little fresh air will do him good.
I wish that you speak to him now.
Yes, Mama.
Thank you. And, I shall tell Hill and Cook to prepare the recipe for you at once.
Don't hurry away, Charlotte. I wish to speak to you about the ball at Netherfield.
Oh, everyone is saying how much attention Mr. Bingley paid to Jane.
It did seem as if he admired her.
Well, is Jane happy?
Very happy. Do you know how she is? So composed, very happy. Get at her true feelings.
It's a mistake for me to conceal her affection with too much skill. Mr. Bingley likes your sister, undoubtedly. But he may never do more than like her. She does not encourage him.
Of course she does encourage him, as much as her nature will allow. If a woman is partial to a man, he must find it out.
In 9 to 7 to 10, a woman better show more affection than she feels. The time to fall in love, how does she assure him?
Not Jane, for love knows no design.
You didn't fare so well before, Lizzie.
Oh, that hateful Mr. Darcy. You know, I heard him talking about me.
You did? Oh, Lizzie.
Mr. Bingley suggested that he might ask me for that. And I'm fine, Mr. Darcy said. She was tolerable, I suppose, but not handsome enough to tempt me.
Poor Liza. Only just tolerable.
Indeed, if he were to like me, I should be quite put out.
Oh, hello, Mary.
Reading again.
Oh, hello, Charlotte.
In a way, Mr. Darcy's pride is understandable. A fine young man with family fortune and everything in his favor has a right to be proud.
I can forgive his pride if you're not mortified, Mark.
Well, you know, pride is very common, Ben, I believe. Well, to either way, I'm convinced that human nature is partially bound to it. Indeed, there are few of us who not share quality some score or another, real or imaginary.
Oh, yes, indeed. I must get those recipes before I leave.
Vanity and pride are different things, though the world.